Hey guys, I'm going to do another video on Rink Rake. As you can tell, I snapped mine, but I still got this piece. So I'm going to resalvage this. I went out and I bought myself a 10 foot length of the same type of pipe, that's 3/4 inch, a T, two caps, a coupler for the end of this one here. And this cement, I had to go buy another one because obviously it dries up pretty quick. Need a drill, tape measure, marker. Let's get started. This is all going to be one video, so it might be a little long. First, I'm going to do 3 foot sections to attach to the sides here. So let's get them measured and cut right now. And you need a hacksaw, of course. My bad. So these right away, try to take off little bits of that, the filings on the end of it. Next up is a measure, 1 inch intervals for the holes. You're gonna have to drill holes. This is a tricky part, it's a little bit time consuming, but do your best, that's it. I've learned a trick with these holes to, let's see if we get in here. To face them towards you as you pull it back. You don't want them going straight up. You want them more or less shooting back towards you as you pull it to create like a little puddle. So I'm going to try that this year to see how that works out. Oh, next one. I used mine today, an old cloth one, and it finally gave way. It was pretty darn cold out today. I think I woke up, it was minus 23. I had to remove about 8 inches of snow. And I let it sit outside, which I usually don't do, but that was my mistake. and I paid the price for it. Now I gotta make a new one. So I advise bringing it in, draining the water out of it. Just like that. So the measuring tape part, done. Next is the fun part. Try not to get your hands all screwed up here. Let's back her up. There we go. You start drilling. Lost it. I'll go around and clean up all the flashing that's left over. You don't have to necessarily, but try to get it as straight and as perfect as you want. To me, it doesn't matter, as long as it's within a close proximity of where it is, it'll still work. Sharper bit will probably work better. This is not sharp by any means. I want to get one more coat on it, the rink today. Got hockey practice for little guys out here today. And tomorrow they play their winter classic, which is gonna be cool. Bugger. So I don't know if you want to sit here and watch me do all these, but I'll show you what it's like when it's done. Okay guys, got one done. And you see, I got little nubs, I'm gonna call them nubs, on top here. All you need is a good knife. Good knife like that. And all you gotta do is just slowly pick at them like that. Dig them out if you want. Take out as much as you can, and that'll affect the way the water comes out. But just go over like that. That way it's a lot smoother, water will come out, it won't have going crazy directions or whatever. So I'll drill holes in the other one, I'll clean them both up, and then I'll continue from there. Alright guys, got it all done, as you can see. They're about an inch apart, as best as I can do. Both of them the same. May not be so straight, but whatever. I'll make it do. Next, I need to put the T. First, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna measure some stuff. I wanna put this in here, but I also want the coupler to go here to give it a little bit more strength, because this is where it snapped last time. So I'm gonna cut a little piece off there. I'd say 1/2 inch. Right? So we're cutting her right about there. I rough ball everything. I don't get exact measurements. If something that looks like it'll work, then I'm game for that. Stick the burrs off. You don't want the burrs inside because they will they may clog a hole and create uneven pressure. Then you'll have one side that's heavily watered and one side that's not so watered. Just need to dry fit it. That. I gotta cut a little bit more off. This will be tricky. All cut. I just want this piece to go in there a little bit, like so. And I want this piece to come on top and fit in there. I can probably squeeze those two together and it'll be just like that. I got a little bit of a gap, but whoop-de-doo. Still has more support. So I'm gonna glue those up and glue stuff together right now. Hopefully. Need tools, you never have them where you need them. Love them. Alright, here we go. Glue, do the shape. Oh man, why is everything hard today? Okay guys, I got all the holes done and deburred as best as I can. Cut myself a little piece here off the end, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a coupler, put this inside the coupler, and then put that one piece that goes into the T for those two things, the water spikes I'm going to call them, glue them together, push it together so it's more rigid. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. And don't be shy on the glue. The more the merrier. There we go. And that's what you're gonna end up with. I got a little bit of a gap because I didn't measure, but still got a lot of strength in there. Next, I'm gonna attach it to my down spigot, I'm gonna call it. So I'm gonna glue the crap out of that, stick that on. The more glue, the better. The stuff sets up pretty quick, so make sure you got it where you want it. I got it where I want it. Next, I'm gonna put these pieces on. I use a lot of glue. Never have enough. And this you gotta be really tricky with, because you gotta get the which way you want these things facing right away, or else you're stuck. And that will work for me right there. Bingo, yep. So I'll do the next side. Try to match it up. That looks good to me. So now, you've got your rink rake 3/4 of the way built. I just need caps on the end. So we'll do that right now. Here's the second one. And that's it. Wipe your glue off wherever. Stuff is sticky as heck. And that's the stuff I'm using. Cost, let's say $7. And then that's it. You guys got a rink rake built. It's gonna be a 6-foot span right here. And the handle, I'd have to say, is 4.5 feet. Because I'm not a tall guy. But the way it sits, that's perfect for me. And I'm gonna go try it out when this stuff dries in a couple minutes.